Aloha. You're watching Cradle Point, part of Ericsson's demo series, where you get hands-on how-to from Cradle Point experts. Now, we're excited today because we're going to share a little bit about our new NetCloud Secure Access Service Edge solution, and it's optimized for 5G environments, allowing you the confidence to connect anything, anywhere. And I'm really excited. We've kind of chatted a little bit. I'm really excited to have the lead product manager on, Daniel Scarberry. Daniel, how's it going?
It's pretty good, Peter. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good myself. So, you know, Daniel, one of the claims we make in the NetCloud SASE solution is that we can, or our customers, I should say, can set up a network in 6 minutes, or under 6 minutes is the claim. So we're here to basically prove that out. Are you ready to do it?
Absolutely. Let's take a look. Let me share my screen and let's do it in 6 minutes. You got the stopwatch ready?
And let's start the clock.
All right. So I'm going to go ahead and start out here. And you can see NetCloud Manager from day zero is a multi-tenant supported architecture. So I already have three networks built out, but that's for later in the demo. For the 6 minutes, let's go ahead and start our add button, and we're going to create an entirely new Secure Connect Zero Trust network. So let's give this a name, and today I'm going to work through an entire retailer's enterprise policy, from the branch, from the IoT, all the way to the remote worker. So we'll call this the retailer. And we're going to deploy this in our Ashburn region, and we're going to finish this up, and that's going to start creating that network. So while that network's created, that's your 3 to 5 minutes from now. And let's say that first minute there was just for me to introduce Secure Connect. So this is going to be the service gateway hosted in the cloud in a microservice unified policy architecture. So while that's provisioning, why don't I go ahead and walk through some of our key use cases and create the policy for this entire retailer?
Sweet.
So I'm going to go ahead and click on the large retailer, and this is just a mimic of that other network that's being created now. And today's demo, we're really focused on our policy-based use cases, really focused on advanced web security services, as well as secure web gateway type of scenarios. So with that, I'm just going to walk through a few policies. The first one, I'm going to go ahead and click the add button on access policy and allow or deny. Well, allow or deny is pretty straightforward. I don't need any advanced engines for this. Well, how about web category based enforcement of acceptable use policies? We see this not just in the retailer space, but across any vertical. So I hope today the policies I create help you understand these relate to fire departments, mobility sectors, retail sectors, IoT sectors. And in this case, we're just going to deny traffic to very specific categories. Now, in a retailer, we oftentimes will see that there's no user-based authentication. It's a point-of-sale system, and it's a shared point-of-sale system. So we'll go ahead and do this at the site level and say any site, any user is going to get this policy applied. This is going to be global across the retailer. Now, when we go to two, we're going to do that web category-based enforcement, and it's going to be on a very specific category. We're taking acceptable use policy and putting it into a technical enforcement now. In this case, we could say we don't allow gambling at this location or the entire company. In this case, it's an ad. Pretty straightforward. It's a deny. There's no need to do further malware prevention or any other advanced reverse browser isolation if we're going to deny the traffic. So this is a top-down hierarchical policy engine. So we are going to go ahead and deny if anything hits this first. That means, well, what about policy number two? Well, policy number two, we might want to start adding something like malware prevention for the rest of the internet. That's a pretty good one, Daniel. So why don't we provide malware prevention? And how do you do that? You apply AV and content disarm and reconstruction. Content disarm and reconstruction, short for CDR. This is going to use a profile. We have these profiles, and this one is actually part of our basic profile. So I'm going to put basic at the front of this just so we can reflect on this in a moment. Again, these are global policies that I'm creating right now that I want to apply to remote workers, third parties, on-prem retail workers. And in this case, AV and CDR, we're going to do this to the entire internet. Anything we allow, why would you not inspect it for malicious intent? So we're absolutely going to do that. We're going to take our advanced web security services here and enable it this time. And this time we chose that basic profile. Notice we have four profiles, and I'm going to walk through each of these profiles during this demo today, really trying to hone in on when do I use a basic profile? When do I use a safe profile? When do I go full isolation, Daniel? So any internet, this is a great use case here for going with basic AV and CDR for malware prevention.
So I see a little notification down there. I keep an eye on the clock. We got a minute 45. Does that indicate that we're there already?
We probably are there, but let me do one more policy to get that second policy out of the way, and then we'll pivot back over there. And
fair
enough. We're only 45 in, so I got a couple minutes to spare, so I might as well keep this going. I'll keep a good thing going. So if the first one was a basic, really protection mode, right? You want to protect all internet traffic. There's not a third party you wouldn't want to protect. So that was that global one. Well, what about as the malware gets higher risk? So let's keep on the malware prevention use case. And so what if we went to high risk malware prevention? So now that malware prevention is becoming a higher risk to the business. So I'm going to use a different profile this time. And in this case, I'm going to use our secure profile. And in the secure profile, again, global policies. So I'm really not focused on user-based here. And I go into my web category, and we have this next dropdown, which was web reputation. And so I don't care what the web category is, but the web reputation, if it's high risk, I'm going to force a little bit more inspection on this traffic. So in this case, I'm going to run it through full reverse browser isolation, but in high performance mode. So in high performance mode, the customer impact, minimal, almost unrecognizable to the end user that we are performing this browser isolation. And that's because we aren't isolating the browser session in a virtual and then streaming it to the user. We're actually just isolating the malicious objects and scripts within that website. But we're also going to do our antivirus scanning, just like we did in basic, and our content disarm and reconstruction, meaning any file type mismatches, any PDFs that are downloaded, any malicious scripts that are being downloaded in those objects, we're going to clean those up and present them to a user in a protected manner. So that's our secure profile. And again, I'm trying to relate these use cases, not just to retail, but to many verticals, because these use cases exist anywhere in an enterprise deployment and IoT and retailer. It's everywhere. So now we've got two of those profiles. Maybe we'll go back and check that network at this stage.
I think we did, because the timer did go off.
All right.
Moment
let's go
of truth.
So we go over here, and it's provisioned. So we're
good. There we go.
We got our timer.
Really neat. Cool. Well, thank you so much, Daniel, for this. It actually was like a pretty cool demo. I want to get hands on myself on this. So I really appreciate it. Hopefully you enjoyed this demo too. Folks, if you'd like to learn more about NetCloud SASE, of course, you can visit cradlepoint.com. If you like content like this, give Daniel a like, hit that subscribe button, because we're going to be doing a lot more of these in the demo series. Hey, I really appreciate your time, Daniel. Let's get on again and do something else. How's that?
Sounds good. Have a good one, Peter.
Thank you. So for Daniel, I'm Peter, and we're with Cradlepoint. Thanks for watching.